late this evening, but we're on air in 30 seconds. Please welcome Jools Holland and the Rhythm and Blues Orchestra. Here they are.
Lights, cameras, action! All systems ago as we rev up for another explosive hour of harmony, hilarity, and hot, hot holidays! Yes, it could be any one of our intrepid travellers who've come from far and wide tonight. John and Steve spent £240 to get here from Belfast. Hope you don't need the return, boys. Josie and Sam are prepared to drop everything to be with us. Well, almost everything. And Lorraine and Greg have pogoed together all the way from Glasgow. Oops! Their suitcases are sizable. Yes, their passports are stampable and their toothbrushes are usable. And they're all going gaga for another large helping of Don't Forget Your Toothbrush too. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the man who won't leave his dressing room for anything less than half an hour, Mr. Christopher. Look out, I'm coming, Evans!
Belinda Carlisle will be over there. She's going to be on the show tonight. Also, we could be jetting two members of tonight's audience off to beautiful Bermuda. And this evening, we don't have a hidden camera outside one house. We have a hidden camera outside lots of houses. But that's all later. Now, you don't want to know about later, do you? You want to put no out now, because that's all I'm talking about. What's going to happen right now? Yeah! Well, I got a question. question for you. Do you like the Thunderbirds? Do you like the Thunderbirds?
Yes!
Do you like Captain Scarlet?
Yeah, I'm sure. Yes!
Do you like Joe 90?
Yes!
See, the thing is, Joe 90 is my favourite, but is Joe 90 worth liking? Is he worthy of our adoration? Well, I think he might be, but tonight we just want to check, you see. So we're asking, is Joe Normal as good as Joe 90? Started, we plucked three genuine Joes out of the audience, and here is the first Joe. Hello,
hello.
Joe. How are you?
Nice to meet you.
So, which Joe are you then?
I'm Joe Riddy.
And where are you from, Joe?
St. Caulfield.
Okay, well, we want to know, are you as good as Joe 90? So, tonight your mission will be to hit the big red button in a supermarket. That's right, to hit the big red button in the supermarket, your mission, there it is, that's right, your mission is in a moment your chair's going to start spinning round. And once it stops spinning round, you've got 10 seconds to get off the chair, sounds quite easy, but it ain't, and just wander over there to the button, hit the button. If you hit the button within 10 seconds, your mission will be a success, and you will win £1,000. They'll fall. But please, whatever you do, please don't upset Mr. Rivron, the supermarket owner.
Dried food is my life.
Dried food is his life, you see, so you can't upset him. But before you do all this, before your chair starts to spin, please, a word of advice from Joe's dad. Heed this.
Now, you know what to do. Just relax.
Fine advice, I think you'll agree. I'm going this way, I hope it's the right way. Let's spin the chair.
Shop.
Well, when you get another shot, we'll be back with you with another Joe asking, is Joe Normal as good as Joe 90?
Hello. Hello, Jules.
Hello, Chris.
How the devil are you?
I'm very well. This is live. It's exciting.
This is live. It's a good one tonight, isn't it?
It's very exciting.
It's already like a greenhouse in here.
Yes.
So, a very nice greenhouse, very friendly one.
The greenhouse effect.
Yes. Julian?
Yes, Christopher.
Tell us about tonight's musical artist, please.
Tonight's musical artist started in Los Angeles as the Misfits. They then became the Go-Go's. They had a huge amount of tremendous hits. Belinda Carlisle was with them, and then she left them, and now she's back with them. So, in the fore of the stage, we have the Go-Go's, and at the top of the stairs, we have...
See, what we're saying is we've got 75% of the Go-Go's here, 25% of the Go-Go's up there, and that 25% is Belinda Carlisle!
To act through.
house manager Paul Harbour from Southport.
There's Paul! Hello, Paul, how are you doing?
I'm not too bad, Chris.
Paul, meet Linda. No, don't meet Belinda, so I'm getting too formal. No, too informal. Meet Belinda. Come on, I don't believe you've kissed yet. Lips haven't touched. Well, please, let us touch now! Nobody will believe you, Superman. Then our whole competition will be controversial. We don't want that. So you're 24 years old, you're from Southport in Merseyside. How long have you been a fan of Belinda's sport?
Since about 1987.
So that makes you, what, 17? 16?
Yeah, around that.
Okay, why do you like her so much? What's so good about her?
The music's great and she's...
gorgeous.
Drop dead gorgeous.
Yes,
so.
Absolutely. Have you met him before, Belinda?
Actually have, a couple of years ago.
Where was that?
In a hotel.
No way! So, you're not kissing because you feel guilty about some past experience, is that what it is? There's a bit of, like a couple who divorced and haven't met for a while. So what have you brought Shania and Belinda win?
Paul? Well, I brought my guitar.
A guitar?
Yeah. Bought for my 15th birthday present, so it's very sentimental to me.
Is that a beginner's guitar, Paul?
It is, yeah.
What are you trying to say about Belinda then?
Well, I think she needs to learn to play an instrument.
Yeah,
do you not
so.
Play an instrument, Belinda?
I stopped playing guitar when I had to learn the F chord.
Really? The F chord? It hurts your finger, doesn't
it? Yeah, it was too
absolutely.
Tough.
Absolutely. So, what have you brought your Paul in?
I brought a bra that's seen better days.
A bra that's seen better days? A bra that you've worn out, you described it as in rehearsal.
Well, you could say maybe it's worn out.
No, sure. Will you be happy to win that, Paul?
Oh, sure. Yes.
If you don't, I'll have it. No. Okay, ready? Here we go. It's questions on Belinda. Who knows more about her, Belinda herself, or Paul, a superfan? Start the clock and start it now. Who directed the video for the song Heaven is a Place on Earth? Yes!
Thank you.
Is the right answer. What was the title? No time for whooping in the quiz! More questions. What was the title of the Go-Go's debut album? Yes, Belinda. Is the right answer. Why did Belinda post nude in 1990? Yes, Paul.
We'd rather go on Go-Go make it more
fur. For an anti-fur post campaign, it's the right answer. Stop the clock right there. I'm glad you knew the answer to that one. And Belinda, would you like to post nude now?
Sure. Right
yes.
Now?
Don't tempt them, whatever you do.
Don't
tempt them, whatever you do. No. Start the clock. Here we go. What did Belinda have a craving for when she was pregnant? Yes, Belinda.
Vinegar
is the right answer. Which film has Belinda seen more than 15 times? Yes, Belinda.
The Delta Meter.
Is the right answer. Who co-wrote the Go-Go's hit Our Lips Are Sealed? Yes, Terry Hall, fine man. Which former president did Belinda's husband, Morgan, once work for? Belinda.
Reagan.
President Reagan. Stop the clock. What did he do for President Reagan?
He was the youngest special assistant to the president in the history of the United States.
Right. Great. But it sounds impressive. Start the clock. Here we go. Which singing legend did Belinda and the Go-Go's perform with last week at the American Music Awards? Belinda!
Little
is the answer. And Paul, you're lagging behind. Who is Belinda's favourite cartoon character? Yes, Belinda!
I don't know.
Eat my pants! Eat my pants and eat them now. It's a clue. Bart Simpson is the answer. Who lived in Belinda's Hollywood home before she moved in? Yes, Paul.
Carol Lombard.
And? Clark Gable. Sorry, you still get the 5 points. What does Belinda say has been the most frightening thing she's ever seen? Yes, Belinda.
A ghost
when she was 17. Stop the clock right there. That may be true, Belinda, but don't you think this picture of you in your punk days is also slightly frightening? is that a close second? Yes? I think it is. Okay, stop the clock again. What was Belinda's dad's profession? Yes, Paul.
Carpenter.
He was a carpenter, and what a fine group they were. Will you tell them for me? How many brothers and sisters does Belinda have? Yes, Belinda.
Six
at the last count. How old was Belinda when she had her first kiss? Belinda.
13.
15 we've got here. I'm not quite sure you know better than me. Maybe you was 13. We'll just make the boy question. Which film company offered Belinda a lucrative contract in 1986? Belinda.
Disney.
Stop the clock. Why did you say no?
Because I don't really want to be an actress.
Okay. Stop talking. Who were Belinda's co-stars in the film Swing Shift? Yes, Paul.
Colonel Saul Goldicott.
Is the right answer. What colour underwear does Belinda always wear? Yes, what's the answer, Paul?
White cotton.
What?
White cotton.
White cotton is the right answer. Stop the clock there, but we've just seen the black bra. I don't get this. Now, I know that it's white because that's what her idol Elvis Presley liked women to wear. Is that right, Belinda?
Yes, sir.
But where's the black bra come from? The black bra's not yours, is it?
Well, when I wear black shirts and black things, I always wear
white. But you prefer to wear white underwear. Kevin for that. Okay. Stop talking. Here we go. What is Belinda's favourite perfume? Belinda! Yes, it's very close. Which rock group did Belinda's doctor forbid her to see when she was 8 months pregnant? Belinda!
You too
is the answer. He said she couldn't see Dire Straits because they weren't exciting a talk is apparently some of you two would have forebode your pregnancy. Is it over? Good summer! You put it to a 50% And you sort of faded out instead of stopping.
No, I continued and then stopped.
Okay. We should have asked. Welcome back to the show. Here we are, part two of Getting a Toothbrush. And now, this show's a lot of things. But most of all, I'd like to think it's a sexy show, if you don't mind. for the boys we have JD. She's always here for you boys. Of course, for the girls we have the dapper, the suave Jools Holland, he's over there. And for the people who are slightly left of the field, not quite sure, we do have John, of course. John is there. Maybe that's why he's sort of tailed out a bit there. He's worried about this next bit. But you know, it can be sexy, this show, as long as you're sexy. And the sexier you are as a person, the sexier the show will seem. But it's very hard to be sexy on your own. And there are some people in the audience in that situation this evening, a situation also known, of course, as being single. Members of our audience, whether they're single or not. Are you single, madam?
Yes.
You are single. But you look happily single somehow.
I'm very happy.
Yeah, I'm sure you are. Are you single, madam?
Yes.
You are single. Yeah. You don't look so happily single as the lady behind. She looks like she has a good night every night, just riding on the crest of a wave and, you know, just dabbling in, being a little bit eclectic. But you do look happy. I'm not saying you don't look happy, but you don't look as happy as she does. I mean, have you tried to find Mr. Wright at all?
Oh, yes.
You have tried to find Mr. Wright? I know you've tried to find Mr. Wright, Judith Palmer from Leicester. I also know some of the guys who have failed to make the grade, and they're here this evening. That was Jonathan Kenton, of course, who is a nurse at the hospital where you are training at the moment. You met him over a curry, and you stayed together for just 7 months. 7 months! Until one night you realised he wasn't the man for you, and you dumped him in a Leicester nightclub. And then there was Richard Vines. Who could forget Richard Vines? He wooed you with his wolf whistles when you passed his building site on the way to school. But after only 2 weeks, luck turned to shove and you ditched him for an old flame. And here is that old flame, your childhood sweetheart, Kevin Featherstone. You were 16 when you first kissed and you dated for 2 years. But you left him for the second time when you realised he was never going to be your perfect partner. Tonight, as far as you're concerned, well, tonight, Judith, what we think it's our duty to do is to send you out searching for the perfect partner. But where are we going to send her? Well, we're going to send you to Chinatown, Judith. Because you see, the thing is, we figure if you can't find Mr. Wright, you should settle for Mr. Wong. Come with me, come on, let's go. Come on. Is Joe Normal as good as Joe 90? Joe Costley, then! This is Joe Costley, everybody! Joe, you genuinely were plucked out of our audience, weren't you, before the show started?
Nope.
You were, as a genuine Joe, for heaven's sake. Where are you from?
Bangor.
Okay, Northern Ireland?
Yep.
Okay, come over just for the show?
Special.
What a guy, come over all the way just for the show. Special to have you here. Is Joe Normal, that's you, as good as Joe 90, all our heroes. Well, let's find out, your mission is to hit the big red button in a flower shop. And there it is. It's Roland Smells Flower Shop, that's what it is. And once again, you'll be spun around in this chair in a moment or two. Then once it stops, you'll have 10 seconds to hit the big red button. That's your mission. If you do that within 10 seconds, you two are showered with £1,000 this evening. Yeah. To take back to Northern Ireland. But whatever you do, please don't upset Mr. Rivron, the flower shop owner.
Hey, flowers can be fun.
Yes, they can be fun. They will be. Before we start spinning your chair, a word of advice from Joe's dad.
Just relax. Relax completely.
Okay, let's spin the chair. Here we go. Thank you.
think you're doing?
Roland, what are you going to do?
I'm going to get a different shop. This is obviously not working.
Are you going to buy another shop?
I'm going to buy another shop.
Okay, we'll see you in your new shop.
Good!
With another Joe.
Always!
Let's go!
They finished. Good.
Okay, coming up in a moment, we'll be back in Chinatown live, hopefully with Judith Palmer, but now please welcome back with the Go-Go's, Belinda Carlisle, yeah? To hopefully send two members of our studio audience off to Bermuda. In a moment, we're going to go back live to Chinatown, but now it's time to talk to those people, the people we love, the people at home. Yes, the people at home, that's you watching the show right now. Tonight's a very special evening, because as always, we like to flash your living room lights, because we could have a camera outside your house. But tonight, our camera's not outside just one house, it's outside lots of houses. And we're looking... We're looking for the liveliest living room light, so flash them quick and keep them flashing, because it could be you, and we're coming to your house in 10,
9, 8, 7, 6, 9, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Let's go to the people at home. And we have a housing estate. We have a housing estate. There are people flashing nowhere. Oh yes, there's one flashing there. I can see one at the top left, I can see one at the far right. Actually, there's quite a lot flashing, apart from the one in the one we can see. We don't want the one we can see, because they're not flashing. Let's go, let's move the camera. Let's get the camera on the move, and let's find a house that's more worthy of our visit. Okay, keep going, and we're happy. Oh, there's people flashing in the distance. Oh, look! Yes, there are a couple of hundred people flashing now. Okay, let's go. Where should we go? Right or left? Forward. Left. Okay, we need to go anywhere. Should we go there? Can we go there? Okay, let's go. Let's keep going. No, let's keep going. Let's keep going. It was a little slow taking off, but then we had hundreds of houses flashing, and I can tell you that the whole estate was flashing, and they were the Redwood Avenue estate in Killamarsh in Derbyshire, and the people there can't believe it. They were one of many. They were flashing the quickest. That's where we're going to be. Now, whoever's there in your house, get them to open all the windows, please, upstairs, downstairs. We're going to play the game in a moment, and while you're doing that, whoever you are, oh, they're at it already, we're going to tell you some facts about Killamarsh in Derbyshire. Fact number one, Killamarsh's original name, Chinworldy Marsh, or Chiniwold, which was a Saxon chief who owned the local marsh. Fact number two, in 1846, the population of Killamarsh was just 1,200. Today, this number has swelled to a massive 12,000. And fact number three, the oldest pub in Killamarsh is the Nag's Head, and its oldest regular is 94-year-old Arthur Batty, who lives next door. There are three facts, the only three we could find about Killamarsh in Derbyshire, but there you are. Okay, are you two ready to play the game? Yes, okay, there's four people in there. Okay, we're gonna ask you to throw 10 things out of some windows in your house. Throw the right 10 things out of the right windows and you'll win £1,000 this evening, whoever you are. Okay, ready to play? Let's play the game and let's start the clock right now. Throw a pillow out of the bedroom window, upstairs. Throw a yellow pages out of the living room window, A telephone out of the bedroom window. Get the telephone. Where is it? Hey! Just throw it out. No, it's not gone. Yes, it's gone now. Throw a duvet out of the front door. A duvet. There comes the duvet down the stairs, and it's going to go. Where's it going to go? Come on. There you are. Tray or drawer out of the bedroom window. Cutlery tray or drawer upstairs out of the bedroom window. Come on! For £1,000, you've got to get 10 things out. You've got to go quicker. It's no good. You've got to be quicker than this. Where's the cutlery tray? There it is. Okay, throw your kitchen bin out of the downstairs window. You've got to go. You're too slow. Too slow, it's not gonna work. Come on! Okay, get out of there. Throw a dressing gown out of the bedroom window. Throw a plant out of the front door. Come on, please. Okay, there it is. Okay, throw a sofa cushion out of the downstairs window. There you go. Throw an ironing board out of the bedroom window. Yeah. yesterday we were at the Glenwood Avenue Estate in Kilmarnock in Derbyshire. Throw the £1,000 in. Where's your £1,000? Get ready to catch it. There's your £1,000. Go and get it. Have a drink on us. That was Kilmarnock. That was a little town in Derbyshire. The excitement rolls on. I believe we can go back live now to Chinatown. Yes! Chinatown, and there she is. Hello, Judith.
Hello.
This is Judith Palmer. Judith Palmer, originally from Leicester. And Judith, just let me recap on the situation for you and everybody else. You are single.
Yes? Yes.
Okay, that is correct. Yeah. That is correct, actually. You are single. You should know that. Now, you've been searching for Mr. Right. You can't find Mr. Right. So tonight, we've sent you to Chinatown to look for Mr. Wonk. Now, yeah, it is quite funny, isn't it? Now, if you look over your left shoulder, just look over your left shoulder, you'll see a restaurant called the Friendly Inn. Yes, can you see that?
Yep. Okay. Yep, see it.
Well, Mr. Wonk is in there, Judith. Now, what you've got to do is you've got to go up to all the tables and tap them on the shoulders very politely, because there will be some members of the public in there, and just say, excuse me, are you Mr. Wonk? So off you go, go on, off you go, as quick as you can. As quick as you can, go and see Mr. Wonk. You're looking for a Mr. Wong. You're going to say, excuse me, are you Mr. Wong? Hello, are you Mrs. Wong? Is Mr. Wong at the toilet? Hello, go on, ask some people. Yes?
Excuse me, are you Mr. Wong?
No, 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 Mr. Wong.
Are you Mr. Wong?
Yes. No, he's afraid not. He'd like to be. No, come on, ask some more people at the tables there.
Hello, excuse me, are you Mr. Wong?
No. No, 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 I don't think he's lying. I think he's telling the truth. Okay, move on then. Anybody else to the right there? To the right, to the right. You don't ask those people.
Okay. Excuse me, are you Mr. Wong?
No, that's a girl. That was a girl. Just a short haircut. Okay, where are you going to go now?
I don't know where I'm going.
I think there's an upstairs. Do you want to go upstairs? See if Mr. Wong's upstairs. Okay, ask the next person in a Chinese accent. Ask, because they might not be able to understand you. So I say, excuse me, are you Mr. Wong? Go on, ask someone.
Excuse me, are you Mr. Wong?
No, he's not. He's not even interested in anything at all. Okay, ask that guy.
Are you Mr. Wong?
No, he's not Mr. Wong, no. Anybody else at all?
Are you Mr. Wong? No.
No, he's not Mr. Wong.
Wong.
Yeah. I'm your boy. Oh!
Judith, are they all Mr. Wong?
They are.
Okay. Okay, well, what we'd like you to do with all those Mr. Wongs now, hello, tell them I'm saying hi. Tell them to say hi to us. We want to say hello to all the Mr. Wongs. Tell them to wave and say hello.
Just wave to the camera.
Yes,
say,
please, if you don't mind. Yeah. Hello, Mr. Wongs. Ask them would they like a ride in a black London taxi. Go on, ask them there. Ask them there.
Would you like a ride in the big London taxi?
Yes. Okay, well, get them outside because there are some taxis waiting for them. Bring them back to the studio. Bring them, Mr. Wong, back to the studio. Come on, get them outside and get them back to the studio. Come on, quickly. Come on, hurry them along, Judy. Come on, Judy. Get them, Mr. Wong. We want to see the Mr. Wong. All those Mr. Wongs back here. We could be sending two members of our studio members off to Bermuda, and once again, we'll be asking, is Joe Normal as good as Joe Rowdy? Don't miss part three, the Mr. Wongs are coming. Our trilogy of tests as far as Joe 90 is concerned, because is Joe Normal as good as Joe 90? Alright.
Thank you.
What's your name?
Joe.
Joe, of course it's Joe. Otherwise you wouldn't be here. What's your surname?
Crookshank.
Okay, and where are you from, Joe Crookshank?
Glasgow, Scotland. Okay,
nice to have you here. Well, once again, we're going to be asking, is Joe Normal as good as Joe 90? And your mission will be to hit the big red button in the egg shop. Once again, you've got a spinning chair. Once it stops, you've got 10 seconds to hit the big red button. Not easy. And of course, please, please don't upset Mr. Rivron, the egg shop owner.
Remember, an egg's not just for breakfast.
No, you see, it's not just for breakfast. And if you do all that, of course, you win £1,000. But please relax and have some advice from Joe's father.
You know what to do. Just relax. Relax completely.
That's right. Just relax. Relax completely. And we're going to spin your chair. You ready for this? Remember, it's an egg shop.
Okay.
Here we go, let's spin the £1,000, but once again, she's destroyed your shop, mate.
A newsagent's.
That's what I'll do. Is that what you're going to do?
Yes.
Okay, well, we'll leave you to that. We'll leave you to Joe here.
Joe, you fool!
All that we've been asking is Joe Normal as good as Joe 90. Tonight, we're playing for a holiday to either Bermuda or Bangor. Let's bring on the detonator. If we explode one of your chairs, of course you know the deal by now. Unless your question, get it right. And you need your partner to come down here. You play for holidays to Bermuda. And if you win that holidays to Bermuda, you go this evening! Contenders ready! Detonator ready?
Yes.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1!
No, it's mine.
Oh! Okay, so it's your team's. Alright, mate, who are you with?
Dawn.
Hello, Dawn.
Hi, I'm fine,
yeah, what's
Gary.
Okay, Gary and Dawn, lovely couple. Okay, answer this question correctly, and you two play for holidays to Bermuda, and they're lovely, I'd like to have them down on my stage. What is the headline on page 10 of Tomorrow's Sunday Express? Is it, is your kettle poisoning you? Is your pet poisoning you? Or is your husband poisoning you? A lovely couple, let's play like a me, Belinda! No! Me, Belinda! Gary and Dawn! Hi! It's a distant greeting. Okay, Belinda, if you go over there, sleep star, Okay, ready to play the game?
Yeah.
Where do you want to go?
Belinda!
Where do you want to go?
Banga!
I like you, Don! I like you a lot!
Banga.
Yeah, I'd love to. No! Tasteless, wish I hadn't said it, cut it out of the Sunday repeat, thank you. Okay, so we're in the play, you know, it's very simple. Yeah. Stop it now. I'll keep my eyes off yours if you keep your eyes off mine, thank you. Right, very simple game to play, all you're gonna do, you're gonna question right, and we like 1/16 and you can't tell us. Get 5%. We like your lemon. Get a question wrong though, and we like 1/16 of your. Get 5 questions wrong, we like the top of your plate, and you're going to Bangor. You don't want to go to Bangor, you want to go to Bermuda?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, let's play the world famous Like Your Lemon now! Okay, here we go. First question to you, Dawn. And remember, it's the all-new tough Like Your Lemon. It's first answer only. What do Bermudians call themselves? Do they call themselves shallots or onions? Shallots, and she smiles when she says it, and she's a fool because it's the wrong answer. I'm sorry. Question number two to you, Gary. Gary, why do so many people visit the governor of Bermuda's gardens? To worship the sacred cedar tree or to taste the rare gringy berries?
Taste the berries.
You're going for the berries, the gringy berries.
Yeah.
It's 2 out of 2 wrong, I'm afraid. It was the sacred cedar tree. So here we go. Dawn, Gary's no good to you at the moment.
I know.
Okay. Question number three. Who was conceived in Bermuda? That's conceived in Bermuda. Chelsea Clinton or Bill Clinton?
Bill Clinton!
When does the Bermudian bioluminescent fireworm mate? During a full moon or during a low tide?
Low tide! Low tide!
Low tide!
Low tide?
Yeah.
It's the wrong answer! Another one wrong! Gotta hurry up now! What is the Bermudian slang for rain? Is it sky juice or star drops?
Star drops. Star drops.
Star
drops,
I'll say.
Star juice
or star drops?
I'll say star.
Star
juice
or star drops?
I'll say star.
Star drops.
Star drops is what you're saying. First answer only, it is the wrong answer. One more wrong, you get a banger. You've got to get 4 right to go to Bermuda. What takes place annually in November on the island of Bermuda? The All Breed Champion Dog Show or the National Kite Festival? And if you get this wrong, you're going to banger. The All Breed Champion Dog Show or the National Kite Festival? Kites!
Yeah.
It was your first answer. You get this wrong, you're going to banger. It's.
What? Right, kite. Kite.
The wrong answer! I'm sorry. I'm sorry. It's the wrong answer. Banger! I'm sorry. It is a total disaster, isn't it? Gary! You said banger! Yeah. I'm sorry. Say goodbye to everybody! Say goodbye to everybody! Off you go, get your bags. They're going to banger! Let's say goodbye! They are the only couple to have lost this whole series. But you see, it's the all-new top Like Your Lemon. It's first answer only. And now people definitely won't say as I walk down the street rather innocently, you fix it, we don't fix it, we play it for real, we play it for keeps, and we'll play it again next week. Now, I'm going to say thank you for watching. It's another holiday next week, another day, another dollar. And now, let's go, as long as go, in style.
It's so easy to be in love with you. You make it easy, and it will be exact.
want to make a right. If Justine, are you in this evening? Justine, come down here, please, if you don't mind. She's helped us with all this all week, and your past boyfriends. And the two Mr. Wongs that make a right are John here and Young Chin here. And if you want to stand in there, the reason they're great is because they both got a ticket each for a Caribbean cruise, which leaves Miami on Monday.
Don't forget your toothbrush. Is sponsored by Polaroid.